Hello class 7th, I hope you all are good. Students, as you all know, your exams are commencing from 26th of this month. For each assignment, you will get 2 marks. So send your assignments regularly and on time if you want to get 20 out of 20. And the first term exam will be offline. This will be your offline exam. It means written exam. You have to give your written exam and the sheet we will be providing you. Then after the day when your exam will be held, before 15 minutes, you will get your question paper in your WhatsApp group. Okay. If you have not updated your number, WhatsApp number, please update it. Okay. And same process, 1 hour for your exam. Okay, the duration of the examination is 1 hour, but before 15 minutes you will get your question paper. Reading time 15 minutes, then 1 hour for your writing work for giving exam. Okay, then after taking images of your answer sheet, you have to send them in school WhatsApp number, not in group. Okay, and then you have to submit your answer sheets physically in the school. Okay, students, in last video we could not cross check the answers, we could not cross check the exercises of chapter 2. Okay, today let's cross check the answers of the exercises.
Yes class, these are the exercises of lesson number 2 which we could not do in last video. Let's cross check. Which of the following gases protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays? Ozone. The most stable and calm layer of the atmosphere is stratosphere. Okay. Third one. Which of the following layers of the atmosphere is free from clouds? Stratosphere, free from clouds. Fourth one, ozone hole is found above the continent of, ozone hole is found above the continent of Antarctica. Okay, Antarctica. Which of the following gases is used by refrigerators and air conditioners? Chlorofluorocarbon. Now next one, fill in the blanks. First one, stratosphere is considered the most stable layer of atmosphere. Stratosphere. Number 2, 0.03%. Number 3, burning of fossil fuel. Okay, burning of fossil fuel has contributed to the phenomena of global warming. Fourth one, the ozone hole does not. This you will cut. You just write over there layer. The ozone layer does not allow the harmful ultraviolet rays to reach the earth. Okay, here you will write layer. Fifth one, the most effective solution to the problem of the global warming is to plant more and more trees. Okay. Next one, assign and write their names in the atmospheric layer to which each belongs. Jet planes, stratosphere. Jet planes, stratosphere. Ions, ionosphere. Clouds, troposphere. Meteors, mesosphere. Ozone, stratosphere. Birds, troposphere. Carbon dioxide, troposphere. Hot air balloons, troposphere. Mount Everest, troposphere. Okay. Next one, solve the crossword puzzle with the help of the given clues. An Indian tree known to provide the oxygen round the clock, banyan. Here is the puzzle, solved puzzle which you have to write. Okay, banyan. Number 2, a greenhouse gas, carbon dioxide. You have to solve this puzzle, crossword puzzle, in this form. Okay, you just have to cross check, okay, with your exercise, with your solved crossword puzzle. Okay, you have to do like this.
Yes class, in last video we studied elements of weather. Elements of weather. There we studied what? Atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure and precipitation. Precipitation. Today we are doing temperature. Temperature and wind. Okay. These are two more elements of weather. Temperature. The temperature of the atmosphere can be, the temperature of the atmosphere can be defined as the degree of hotness and coldness of air. The temperature of the atmosphere can be defined as the degree of hotness or coldness of air.
This is 6 is maximum and minimum thermometer. Okay, this narrow glass tube is filled with, here is mercury and this is metal indices, alcohol. This is alcohol, red one, it is filled with here alcohol, and here is mercury. As you know, mercury expands when it hot and contracts when it cools. Okay, metal indices, this, okay, left bulb, right bulb, here is vacuum, and the measurement is given in this form. Minimum temperature of 24 degrees Celsius and the maximum temperature of 30 degrees of a day, of a place, it is measured. Maximum was 30 and the minimum was 24 degrees Celsius. This is Fahrenheit thermometer. In Fahrenheit, the freezing point is 32 degrees Fahrenheit and the boiling point is 212 degrees Fahrenheit. For most scientific purposes, centigrade scale is preferred. Its freezing point is zero. Okay, freezing point is zero and the boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius.
The difference between maximum and minimum temperatures in a day is called diurnal range of temperature. The difference between maximum and minimum temperature in a day is called diurnal range of temperature or daily range of temperature. They both are same. If we have to calculate daily range of temperature or diurnal range of temperature, that time what we have to do? Maximum, less maximum to minimum. Okay. Suppose an area of a place maximum temperature is, maximum temperature is, maximum temperature is 46 degrees Celsius. Okay, and the minimum temperature is 16 degrees. Okay, 16 degrees Celsius. Then what we have to do? Maximum temperature is 46 degrees Celsius. 46 minus 16. Okay, 46 minus 16. the answer will be 30. Answer will be 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, 30 degrees Celsius will be diurnal range of temperature of this place. Okay, or daily range of temperature. For mean temperature, mean or average temperature. Average temperature, what we have to do? Maximum plus minimum divide by 2. Maximum, in last question only, maximum was 46 degrees Celsius. Okay, and the minimum was 16 degree, divide by 2. 46 and 16. Divide by 2 and the average or mean temperature will be 31 degree Celsius, mean temperature. Okay, we have to calculate in this with this formula. Maximum here, maximum plus minimum divided by 2. This is the formula to get mean or average temperature. Alcohol and mercury are used to graduated glass tubes to measure temperature. They are filled in a narrow glass tube. Okay, alcohol and mercury. Celsius C and Fahrenheit F are the units of temperature. It may be mentioned that India has adopted Celsius as the standard unit of temperature. India has adopted standard unit of temperature as Celsius. In a weather station, the Stevenson screen is used to keep the thermometers in a box which gives us temperatures in shade. The automatic thermometer called thermograph is used to record the temperatures continuously on a graph paper. This is an automatic thermometer called thermograph and is used to record the temperatures continuously on a graph paper. The normal temperature of human body is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 Fahrenheit and is measured by clinical thermometer, that is called clinical thermometer. Now, wind. The wind blows due to the difference in the atmospheric pressure. Wind blows due to the difference in the atmospheric pressure. It blows from the areas of high pressure. Where will be the high pressure? In low areas, lowland, like sea, coastal areas. There will be high pressure. To the areas of the low pressure, and the pressure will be low in the highlands. Okay, so it blows from the areas of high pressure, lowland to highland, high pressure to the areas of low pressure. This movement of air is called wind. This movement areas of high pressure in lowland, high pressure is there in lowland to highland, low pressure, lowland, high pressure. Okay, this movement of air is called wind. Thus, wind can be defined as horizontal movement of air from one place to another. Another place due to the difference in air pressure. The instrument used to know the direction of wind is wind vane. Okay, the instrument which tells the direction, that is called wind vane. While the instrument which tells us the speed of the wind, that is called anemometer. Okay, anemometer. The speed of is measured knots. Okay, the speed of wind is measured in knots. A knot is equal to one nautical mile or hour. Okay, this answer you will write here. What does the term knot denote in context of wind? The speed of wind is measured in knots. One knot is equal to nautical mile hour. Beaufort scale is used for measuring wind velocity based on the observed sea conditions. Geopedia, it is written, a sudden strong wind is called gust, while the violent disturbance of atmosphere with strong wind, rain and thunder is called storm. Wind with rain and thunder, that is called storm. Light gentle wind, which has a soothing feeling, especially on a hot, sultry day, is called breeze. If it blows in sea, from sea, it is called sea breeze. But when it blows from land, that time it is called land breeze. Wind and breeze are two sides of same coin. If it is soothing, it is called breeze. If it is harsh, it is called wind. Maybe hear the sound of wind. We can hear the sound of wind. But breeze blows silently. It doesn't make any sound. That time, the wind which is blowing, but not, which is blowing silently. That is time breeze. But when we can hear the sound, that time wind. Okay, Lu is a hot wind blowing in northwestern India. This is
wind vane. Okay, this is wind vane. The instrument used to know the direction of the wind is called wind vane. It consists of an arrow. Okay, it consists of an arrow pointing towards the direction from which the wind comes. To determine wind direction, a wind vane spins and points the direction from which the wind is coming. The arrow turns. See, the arrow turns into the wind, and the wider part catches the breeze. The arrow points, see, you can see here, the arrow points to the direction from which the wind is blowing. This time this arrow is showing which direction? North. This time, okay, it means wind is blowing from the north side. This is anemometer. Okay, this is anemometer. Okay, anemometer. It consists of 3 to 4 cups. It consists of 3 to 4 cups attached to horizontal arms. The arms are attached to a vertical rod. As the wind blows, the cups rotate and the rod spins. It spins. The anemometer counts the number of spins, which is used to calculate wind speed. An anemograph is used for continuous measurement and recording of wind speed on a graph paper. This is anemometer. But okay, this is anemometer, and it tells the speed of the wind. In this you can see wind vane is also attached with this. wind vane is also a test. This is anemometer, this is wind vane.
Now clouds, there are four main types of clouds. Number one, cirrus clouds. Number two, cumulus. Number three, stratus. Number four, nimbus. Okay. Height of these clouds are altitudes, height from the sea level. Cirrus clouds, 6,000 to 12,000 meters. Cumulus, 6,000 to 2,000 meters. Stratus, more than 2,000 meters. Okay. And nimbus, less than 2,000 meters.
This is high clouds or cirrus clouds. High clouds contain tiny ice crystals, have feathery appearance. The height of this cloud is 16,000 to 12,000 meters, and they are dry, rainless. If you see this type of cloud, it means no rain. Cumulus, okay, medium cloud, woolly appearance, like wool, woolly appearance, thick enough to obscure the sun and moon, cause heavy rainfall. If you see this type of cloud, it means they can cause heavy rainfall, and they are found at 2000 to 6000 meters. This is stratus clouds, and they are dark gray appearance, flat uniform base. Okay, cause drizzle. They cause drizzle more than, and they are found more than 2000 meters. Okay, more than 2000 meters. Stratus clouds. This is nimbus clouds, less than, height of this cloud is less than 2000 meters. Very thick, dark clouds. Very thick and dark clouds. Mostly we can see, generally we see this type of clouds in rainy season. Okay, bring continuous rain, snow. This type of clouds bring continuous rain and snow. This type of clouds bring continuous rain or snow.
These are some weather instruments, okay, and their uses. Thermometer, it measures the temperature of the atmosphere. Okay, thermometer. Barometer, it measures air pressure. Barometer, it measures air pressure. Rain gauge, it measures rainfall. Rain gauge, it measures rainfall. Wind vane helps to find direction of the wind. Okay, yeah, helps to find wind direction. Wind vane. Anemometer, it measures the speed of the wind. Success maximum and minimum thermometer, it measures the highest and the lowest temperature of the day. Hydrograph, it provides continuous record of rainfall. Okay, hydrograph, it provides continuous record of rainfall. You have to revise, you have to learn these instruments and their uses. Okay. That's all for the day. We will continue this chapter in next video. Thank you.